News. One suspect in custody in the Chowchilla mass kidnap. A hunt continues for two other suspects. I'm David Jackson reporting on the CBS Radio Network. Richard Schoenfeld, 22-year-old son of a prominent San Francisco area doctor, gave himself up to police in Oakland, California Friday night. His older brother James and Fred Woods IV are still being sought. All three are believed to have been involved in last week's kidnapping, either directly or as accessories. Woods is the son of the owner of the rock quarry in Livermore, California, where the 26 children and Ed Ray, their school bus driver, were found last week. Police say they'll probably move the younger Schoenfeld to Madera County for possible arraignment within the next couple of days. Earlier Friday, there were reports that a draft of a ransom note had been found, a note demanding $5 million for the return of the kidnapped children. And police revealed Friday that they have found the three vans they think were used to move the children and the bus driver from Chowchilla, 100 miles north, to the Livermore Quarry. A canning strike in California, that story after this.
What's keeping more cars running young?
Start it up, warm it up, swing into traffic, red light, stop, speed up, slow down, jam ahead, idle. Ever wonder how your car stands the punishment? Ever think of giving it Quaker State Motor Oil to keep it running young? Quaker State, refined only from Pennsylvania-grade crude oil. Use it regularly and you'll help avoid expensive engine repairs.
Quaker State keeps cars running young.
Your dog or cat can't let you know that roundworms really hurt him so.
Even healthy-looking pets can have dangerous roundworms. So get your pet the Hart's once-a-month wormer. Follow simple directions and it'll stop roundworms before they stop your dog or cat. Use every 30 days and it'll help keep roundworms away for good.
To really make those roundworms go, get the Hart's once-a-month wormer.
President Ford has ordered a special team from the Agriculture Department to California to estimate crop loss from the four-day-old cannery workers' strike there. Federal mediators have joined in those negotiations, but day by day, more fruit and vegetables rot in the fields. According to William Brusnell of Del Monte, the strike couldn't have happened at a worse time.
We're right now getting into the very peak season for clean peaches and just beginning the peak season for tomatoes, which will run on into October.
The American Farm Bureau Federation estimates the strike is costing the farm industry $3 million a day. Seven states have served notice they intend to challenge the legality of the present 13-cent rate for mailing a first-class letter. That rate was made permanent last weekend, but the states involved want judicial review. New Mexico's Attorney General, Tony Anea, says people in his state just aren't happy with postal service.
We had had a great deal of concern expressed by the consumers in the state that the quality of service being provided by the post office was drastically declining and declining very rapidly, while at the same time the consumers were being asked to pay a higher rate for that reduced service.
The states are arguing that the post office is leaning too heavily on first-class mail and not enough on other classes. 4 days ago, it was Ronald Reagan's staff saying their man had gone over the top, past the 1,130 GOP delegates needed for a first ballot nomination. Friday, the Ford camp made the same claim. Chief Ford delegate watcher Jim Baker saying that 15 delegates from Hawaii had swung the president's way and given him the majority needed. Obviously, somebody is figuring wrong, and each camp is accusing the other of psychological warfare. The CBS News count gives Mr. Ford 1,114 and Reagan 1,064, showing neither with enough. The Canadian government came out with regulations Friday night requiring the use of English for all air traffic control at all but six Canadian airports. Last month, Canada's commercial pilots struck, protesting the increasing use of French in tower-to-plane communications. Now, this message.
The worst handicap a child can suffer is not blindness or deafness or cerebral palsy or mental retardation. No, the worst handicap is for a child to be deprived of the chance to overcome his handicap and lead as nearly normal a life as possible. With special education, most handicapped children can learn and do much more than most people expect of them. But millions of handicapped children are still being denied their right to the special education they need to develop their full potential. If you have a child with a handicap, any kind of handicap, physical, mental, or emotional, we can help. Free. Write Closer Look, Box 1492, Washington, D.C., 20013.
A public service message from this station and the United States Office of Education.
The Environmental Protection Agency has given New York City 5 years to stop dumping sewage sludge into the Atlantic Ocean. The order also covers other communities and commercial waste haulers in New York and New Jersey. The EPA says nearly 6 million tons of wet sewage sludge a year goes into the ocean around New York. And they say that's not good for ocean life. David Jackson, CBS News.